Hello my friends, Mina Geek here. This is Gothic 3, a game released in 2006 by Piranha Bytes, a German developer that also created Gothic 1 and 2, some of the best open world games ever made. Yes sir! And these are all the computers and components I'm going to use to test the minimum and recommended requirements. And trust me when I say, things are going to get wild. This game was Crysis before the Crysis. 3 computers, 4 video cards and 1 set of minimum requirements, which reads Windows XP, Pentium 4 at 2GHz or AMD equivalent, Direct3D compatible video card with at least 128MB and shader model 1.4. The game's version is the one released in 2006, so no community patches, no nothing. This is the vanilla state of the game, which had a lot of issues and bugs. Let's start with the minimum requirements, and I'm going to use this computer. Windows XP, 1GB of RAM, Atron XP 2000+, and a GeForce FX 5200. First, the game loads in... Well, the game loads. Let's leave it at that. And then... start slideshow. Usually, you'll have flickers when the game's FPS exceeds the monitor's refresh rate. But here, the FPS is so bad that flickers started to appear. The FPS has gone negative. The game is so slow that it bends reality. It's clear that this town is too much for this poor little computer, so let's go to less demanding areas. The game runs a little better, but let's see some frames. In the wild, we have around 10 FPS, not counting the constant freezes, otherwise we might as well stop the game right now. We're far from the 20 plus FPS target, and once inside the rebel camp, things are not looking good. Don't get me wrong, things are looking good, visually speaking, but not the FPS. No sir, the FPS takes a deep dive. Man, things are rough. Just look at this. No wonder the nameless hero scratches his... It's clear that the FX 5200 is way too slow for this game, and reading the game's manual, we discover that these are the officially supported video cards. Ok, let's use another video card, a Radeon 9800 XL. This should do the trick. Now, we officially have the minimum requirements. Repeat after me. Gothic 3 has no bugs. Gothic 3 has no bugs. Yeah, ok, the performance. 10 FPS in the first town. Not as bad as the FX, but still unplayable. I mean, we're all about the retro lifestyle here, and we've all played games with low FPS back in the day, but this is too much, or rather too little. Just look at these frames. And don't get me started on the freezes. Man, this game has 10 stutters per second. It's unreal. And no, not the Unreal Game Engine, but the Genome Engine, the one used for Gothic 3, which gives us an entire world without any loading screens, but makes the game stutter like mad. Good job. In Oblivion, you walk and walk and from time to time the game will stop and show a little loading text, then continue. I'd rather have that than these extremely annoying freezes each 5 seconds. It's time to bring out the pitchforks and torches. Never mind, torches are a framerate killer. And now for some technical data. The CPU is at 100% most of the time. Obviously, it's an Atom XP from 2002. It will go to 100% when opening Paint. The system memory sits at around 1GB, so it's clear that we need more. The game loads its assets onto the hard drive, hence the constant stutters. The video memory usage is very close to 128MB, which is ok. Verdict for minimum requirements? Absolutely awful, literally unplayable, a shameful disaster, we've been lied to. The recommended requirements are as follows. Pentium 4 at 3.0GHz, here it is, Pentium 4 630, 1.5GB of RAM, ok, who uses 1.5GB of RAM, really? But we must oblige, so 1.5 it is, and ATI X1600 or better, and I'm going to use an X1600 XT, which is better than the vanilla one. Great, now we're going to experience the game in its unmitigated state of visual grandeur, gameplay perfection, and... The game does look nicer, I'll give it that. By the way, I'm using 1024x768 medium settings. Well, after the initial shock, the game somewhat stabilizes itself and gives us around 15 FPS. The first town is very intensive. We have a lot of characters and many of them are engaged in fierce combat. So, if the FPS is decent here, we're not going to have a lot of problems in other areas, I suppose. The FPS is not decent here. After going outside town, we'll have a way better performance, and although we have the inevitable stutters, by the way, you're going to have these stutters even on modern systems. The frame rate is decent, unless you go inside this cave, where the game gets nuts again. If there aren't many objects on the screen, the game runs pretty well, over 30 FPS sometimes. And if you are patient enough to get past the constant stutters, you could have played this game with this configuration in 2006. Repeat after me, Gothic 3 has no bugs, and to be sure, no gameplay bugs. After using the torch, the game dies. It simply can't handle the extra lighting and the new shadows. The recommended requirements are thrown out the window here. The CPU is not staying at 100%, and here we can see that because the CPU has hyper-threading and because Gothic 3 engine supports multi-threading, we have a nice spread of load. The system memory usage is very close to the amount we have on this computer, so I guess the game loads some stuff on the hard drive. The video card memory sits at around 180 MB, way below the recommended one that this video card also has, so we're good. The average FPS, measured with fraps, is 22, and you might say, great, 22 FPS for an RPG is nice, especially for such a good looking one. Yeah, but look at the 1% lows, 8 FPS. This hurts, but this is not all. The 0.1% lows are nothing. 2 is nothing. 2 does not exist when measuring the FPS. Awful. Verdict for the recommended requirements? Well, 1024x768 medium settings is a mixed bag. You will not enjoy the game, that's for sure. 1024x768 low settings? It's okay. Decent, playable, fine. If you had this system in 2006 and loved Gothic 3, you could have finished the game for sure. Oh, the game loads in 1 minute with this configuration. 2 minutes was the loading time for the first computer, the minimum requirements one. But let's test this game with a better computer. Actually, with one of the fastest computers that you could have in October of 2006, the release date for Gothic 3. And so, here we are, playing this game like a champ. 1600x1200, highest settings, no anti-aliasing or anisotropic, 30 FPS, minimal stutters if any. Excellent. First, the game looks amazing at maximum settings. Second, it looks better than Oblivion, but not in the distance. The distance looks horrible. Entering the Rebel's cave gives us some FPS drops, but hey, for a 2006 game without any loading screens, it's okay. The frame rate is amazing, even with the torch. 30-40 FPS during combat is very playable, and considering that this is unpatched Gothic 3, I'm impressed. The computer is a Core 2 clocked at 3.0 GHz, 2GB of DDR2 memory, and the mighty GeForce 7900 GTX with 512 GDDR3 video memory. Piranha Bytes gave us some poor requirements, a path that we could not follow, but here we are, forging our own paths, playing original Gothic 3 on a powerful 2006 computer at 1600x1200 maximum settings. Life is good. Thank you all for watching, and until next time, play Gothic 3 on modern computers and be nostalgic.